Okay, everybody, this is going to be a little bit of a quick one. Fortnite recently put out an update and they've added in conditional buttons here in UEFN. So I thought maybe I would show you guys really quickly how to use those in Verse, because we want to be doing more and more things inside of Verse for our games. First thing we're going to do is head down into the devices and we'll just look up conditional device or button. And drag that in. And when you drag it in, just put it anywhere you want. I've already got one on the stage here in the scene. What we're going to do is we're going to set up the game manager. If you don't know what a game manager is, then I will put a link in the description below of how to create a game manager, which is essentially just creating, if you go into Verse Explorer and then you right click and create a new file kind of idea, you're going to create what I call the game manager, which is our Verse file. So I've already done all that. I'm not going to repeat that stuff. Now, this is our conditional button, and it has a few settings that we can set inside here. The first thing that I set usually is the color. You can make it any color you want. Let's make it green. Why not? Because we're going to collect a cabbage. Now, what it shows on here is a cabbage because I've set it to be cabbage. You can set it to be anything you want and any amount of things that you want. So we're going to do that over in the details panel here, and down inside of key item one, we can set anything we want. Right now I've set it to cabbage, but you can set it to be apple or some kind of gun. You know, who cares? It doesn't really matter. I've set it to be cabbage. Cabbage is what it is. If you want to do more than one item, you can do key item number two and number three. And also, you can set how many key items are required. So let's put five, right? So then you're going to need to have five cabbage to make this button work. So a conditional button means that it requires a condition to be true, and then it will set off a thing. So how do we make this work inside of Verse? So the way we do that is we hop over to our game manager, which is going to be this console here, which is essentially our Verse file dragged up onto the stage. Already covered all that, so let's go into the Verse file. Now, inside of the Verse file, it's so simple. This is a very, very, very simple thing to do. First thing we want to do is we want to make it an editable item. Again, if you don't know what an editable item is, check the tutorial, but to cover it really quickly, it just means that we can connect up an item into our game via the details panel. So, for example, if we select our game manager, now that I've made it editable, over here on the right in the details panel, we can see conditional B, and we want to set it to a thing. And in this case, a conditional button, because that is the type that it is. Inside of Verse, we've set that up. It's an editable. I've called it conditional B. You can call it anything you want. Doesn't matter what you want to call it. Button number one, button number two, some thing button, whatever you want to call it. And it is a conditional button device, and we're going to make that equal to a conditional button device with a colon on the end. Bam, you're done. That part is easy. Once you've done that, when you do select this down here inside of the, when you select your game manager object in the details, you'll see conditional being. That's what connects the cabbage button to your game inside of Verse. Okay, so that's that all explained. What we want to do in the on begin, so when your game begins, you're going to, on begin is going to run, and we're going to go conditional B activated event, and we can take a look inside of Fortnite. If you don't know how to get to here, hang on. So what we'll do is we'll hold control key down and left click on conditional button device, and that will take us to the part in the code that we have access to as developers as to what it can do. And we want the activated event for now. We can do more with this. There's a not enough items event, which would be kind of funny if they didn't have enough items and then suddenly a guard pops out and takes them down or something like that. You don't have enough stuff. Anyways, so we want the activated event. So when it happens, we want the button to do something. So activated event, subscribe. So that's a way to listen for an event that happens, a thing that happens, and we'll call it on button activated. So we're going to run the function on button activated, which is right here. And it's going to pass in the agent. So this is going to pass in the character that activates the button, which should be you in this case. And then we're just going to print out, we met the requirements for this button. I'm going to go back in here because I don't want to spend forever doing this. I'm going to set this back down to one. Now, by default, it's one, but by checking the check mark, you can set it to be any number you want. So if we start this game, okay, so the game has started, and we're going to take a look over. There's so much stuff going on in this right now because I use this for all of my testing. I have a lot of fun playing around with stuff, and you guys have watched. If you watch the channel, then you already know what's going on. But we'll go and collect this cabbage. So we've got our cabbage into our inventory, and then we'll head over to the button, and it says you've got a cabbage. It says you've met the requirements, so hit E, and then we can see on the top left, it says we met the requirements. But if you didn't see that, go into the tab, hit the log, or click tab, go into the log, and it'll say here, we met the requirements for this button. So now I don't have any cabbage, so it's going to show up red. If we go get another cabbage and come on back, it becomes blue again and active. And that's how you use a conditional button with verse. So you can trigger some verse code and make some verse stuff happen. So fascinating stuff. This is all brand new for 25.10. If you're paying attention to what's the latest come out. So that's it for this one. I'll see you guys in the next one.